In this video, what we're going to do is we're going to take a white t-shirt and we're going to add an image to it. And we'll kind of show how to make it look believable with some wrinkles and things like that on it. And then we'll also probably change the color of the shirt too, because, you know, you don't always use white shirts, right? So let's see what we're doing here. All right. So I have an image open. This is a t-shirt. This is actually from a comp CD that I bought years ago. I don't even remember where or what. Cause we don't use them. We usually create our own, but there's a lot of comp stuff out there these days. So if you want to find one of those to start working with, that, you know, be a good idea. If you don't, then just lay the shirt down on the ground on a, get up on a ladder, take a picture of it and use the pen tool, just like we did with the mug, and create your own, right? That way it's unique and different than anybody else's. That's what we usually do. So, but with this, I just wanted to show. So here's a white t-shirt. On a transparent background, I got my white background here, all right? So what I'm going to do is let's go ahead and bring an image in, and we'll start manipulating with it and working it. So we'll go file open. We'll do the same thing as we did in the mug image. We're going to bring it into its own document. I'm going to grab the top tab, bring it all the way to the bottom, just sort of let it go, and then come over here, grab my layers, and drag it into my image, all right? Now, it's really big because it's a huge full-size design that we would create. This is, again, is another one of our stock designs. Obviously not with the type, but with the fish itself. We made this just the image, the design with the text for this video, right? So let's see. Let's go ahead and make it a little bit smaller. I'm going to kind of get it in there. Let me go a little bigger. Hold my option key to move from the center. All right. I think that works. We'll double click it inside of there to set it. So you can see it's on its own layer. I'm going to zoom in to work with it. If you look at the shirt, it's sort of on an angle, right? Slightly cocked, like a 3/4 view almost. And then my image is straight on. So we got to adjust that. So let's go to select the artwork layer, go to edit menu, come down to distort. I think is the first place I'll start. And I'm just going to kind of move these sides in just a little bit, right? To try to get the same angle or a similar angle on the art as it goes with the shirt. Let's go ahead and do that again, because I'm just gonna pull this one down a little bit more, something like that. All right, double click it. So it's looking pretty good. Let's go ahead and go to edit menu again, come down to transform, and let's go to warp and see if we can't massage it a little bit more. And you got to try to visualize. So for instance, this image was taken on a 3D model or, you know, mannequin, obviously. And I just kind of want to make it sort of look like it's on there rather than being a straight on perfect shot like the artwork might have been in Photoshop. Okay. So something like this. And it doesn't have to be perfect at this point. Double click, click off of it. That's getting there. So actually, I think this, let's take a look. Pretty good. Now let's mess with some wrinkles in here. So we got kind of a wrinkle here. Got a couple of them going in this way. One good one there and then one in here for sure. So let's go ahead and create a new layer up on top. Actually, before I do that, let's select, I'm going to select the artwork layer again. And let's go to the filter menu and let's come down to liquify. Okay, liquify is going to open up into its own little world. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. And the way this thing works, like by default, this show backdrop is off. So you just have an image. So what I want to do though, is I want to kind of manipulate just real subtle stuff. It's very small, subtle changes that make it look a little bit more believable. So knowing that, I'm just going to click on this shadow backdrop thing here and it shows me my image. And this opacity will show you that, as we make our changes together on there. So the top of my tool here says forward warp tool. That's all I need. Now I'm going to change the size by left bracket key will make my brush size in Photoshop smaller. The right bracket key will make it larger, right? So what I want to do is wherever there's a shadow here, I just kind of want to click and push. Because there's a shadow because there's a wrinkle, right? So I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. Push some of these wrinkles in. I'll make it bigger and kind of push it. I want the edge of this E to sort of follow along with that wrinkle. So it looks like it might be, you know, distorted because of the way it drapes. So I'm going to come in here and I'll push a little bit because of this wrinkle here. I'll just kind of push in there a little bit. We'll do the same thing here. Maybe kind of push that in and make it a little smaller here and push it up. You kind of want a real small, you know, subtle pushes, right? Maybe pull on this one and push on this one. Anything we're gonna push here, maybe we'll pull it here. All right, so there's no shadows up here, but what I can do is click and push just a touch with a large brush, so it kind of looks like maybe there's a body underneath that, so it's a little bit more believable. But I think that looks pretty good, so I'm gonna just go ahead and hit okay. Right, and then notice it sort of follows along the edge with the wrinkles here, just like that. So it's not a lot. You don't want to do too much because then it's not believable. But for the most part, I think that looks pretty cool. All right. So a couple things left. Remember, we still have to like add some shadows and add some highlights and whatnot. Let's go ahead and do that with this new layer that we put on top. All right. So if I hold my command key or the control key, we click on the artwork layer of right here. Again, I can go to view menu, come down to extras, or just hit command H or control H to hide those selections. I'm gonna hit my B key. It's gonna give me my brush tool. And I'm gonna look at my foreground color. It's white. If I hit the X key on my keyboard, it exchanges the foreground and background color because the background was black. Click up here. I wanna use a soft round brush. That's perfect. Again, my opacity is really low. That's what I'm looking for. And what I'm gonna do, I'm actually working on a Cintiq. It's sort of pushed up and pushed back as a monitor now because of my camera and microphone and all the stuff for a video. But all it is a big giant drawing tablet so I can draw on screen. I'm going to use my Wacom pen here. You don't need this. You can use a mouse, but I highly recommend a Wacom device. It could be a small tablet. Doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be a Cintiq. Tablets are great. And what I want to do is just going to kind of paint in some shadow here, right? Cool. That's enough. Now, one more change. If I come over here to my layer and I go to it says normal. If I change that to multiply, look what happens. It makes the white of the shirt the white in the image, which is believable, right? So what I could do though, because it did get a little darker, if I go to my image menu, adjustments, go to hue saturation, I can saturate it up a little bit, try to get a little bit brighter. All right, that looks good. So for the most part, if I zoom out a little bit, that looks pretty good. It's believable because it's very small, subtle wrinkles in there. I think it looks good. Okay, white shirt's done. Now, what do we do? How do we take this white shirt and make it a colored shirt? Make it green, red, whatever you want to work with, right? So we're going to do that next. When you do that, this is what I'm going to suggest first. We'll turn these two off, the artwork ones off. And just by the way, if I turn on my shadow, you can see that's where I airbrush the shadows, right? So I turn that back off. I'm going to duplicate my white layer, right? And I'm going to turn one of them off and just save it and keep this one here. And the reason I'm going to do that is because we're going to go to image menu adjustments and I'm going to come down to levels. And what I want to do is I want to make all the wrinkles in here a little bit darker. So if I click on the midtones, whoops, still have my selected area, my artwork selected. So I'm going to go ahead and watch. If I do this, right? See that? So now Command D will hide it. So now I want to do the overall thing here. So again, Command L will go to image adjustments levels. It just brings it up. I'm going to move my midtones and kind of darken up the wrinkles a little bit. See, it's just a little bit darker. It's got a little bit more meat kind of to everything. That's all I need. Just a small bump in it, right? So now what we're going to do is going to make an adjustment level. So layer. So if I come over here and click on this adjustment layer, I want a solid color layer. But before I do that, actually, I need to select this artwork because watch what happens if I don't. All right, I want a red one. Well, yep, it gave me a solid color adjustment layer, but it's not what I want because I just want it on the t-shirt, right? So what I want to do at this point is hold my command key and click on my image to select that area, right? Now just my t-shirt is selected. So now again, Command H or Control H in your PC to hide those marching ants. Now I'm going to go to my adjustment layer, click on it, go to solid color, and it's solid black. All right. All I got to do is move it around. So let's say I want to get a nice, maybe a darker maroon style color. Just kind of pick your saturation level, right? With the color that you're working with. Could be any color in this rainbow, right? Could be anything, green, blue, purple, you name it, it's there. So you just want to, I'm going to go with something like this, like a dark maroon style color. So I'm going to hit OK. And now watch, I'm going to change my mode from normal to multiply, right? And now you can see the shirt's wrinkles and stuff in there. So now what we can do again to make that a little bit more, stand out a little bit more. If I go back to my adjustment layer, and I do a curves adjustment, right? Click on this little finger icon thingy. And what I can do is I can click in my shadow side here. And what I want to do, make it darker, I can push it that way. And I can come over here and click in what would be my lighter side, and I can do it this way. See that? So I can control how much of each of those two. And they're very subtle because it's a dark shirt color. But it's still kind of cool because that's showing me that I just got some separation now, right? So let's go ahead and take this up a little bit more. And we'll take some shadow down a little bit more. Let's see. Up in the, maybe here. All right. That looks pretty cool. So I'm going to click out of that. So I can turn that on and off. You can see what we did. You see it a little bit more visibility there. Now, when we do a dark shirt, I got to come back to my artwork layer and change my mode to normal. But it's still too stark and it's not believable. So what I can do is change my opacity and push it back a little bit. About 80% or so makes it look a little bit more believable. But this solid color layer, double click it, I can make it whatever I want, right? Make it darker green, make it a brighter green, whatever you're looking for. That's how you would change that color. So now I'm going to save my PNG again, send it out to the customer, and I'm good to go. So that's how I would do that. All right. My next video, we'll take a look at some really good textured pillow design and how you make it look like it was printed on a concave or, you know, rounded element. Let's do that next.